President Trump weighed in with tough words for the terrorist.
We also have to come up with punishment that's far quicker and far greater than the punishment these animals are getting right now. Because what we have right now is a joke.
President followed that up with a tweet overnight saying the attacker should get the death penalty. Let's bring in our senior White House correspondent Cecilia Vega for more on the White House response. And Cecilia, the president weighing in like this could complicate the court case.
Yeah, George, it could, especially as Brian was just reporting that he hasn't even been charged with a capital offense yet. But the president here, you heard him there in here in the White House yesterday in that cabinet meeting. He also said he'd be willing to send, quote, this animal to Guantanamo. That's a tweet that you're looking at right there. He's not holding back on Twitter either. This tweet came around midnight. The president tweeted, NYC terrorist was happy as he asked to hang ISIS flag in his hospital room. He killed 8 people, badly injured 12, should get the death penalty. But let's go back to that joke comment for a minute here. Sarah Sanders later said that the president wasn't calling the American justice system a joke, that he was basically expressing his frustration with the process. But that is not actually what the president said there. He also over Twitter said that the U.S. will be implementing a much tougher extreme vetting procedures. But George, he didn't offer any specifics on that.
Yeah, he said it would begin immediately, but we don't know exactly what that means. Meantime, later today, big announcement on the economy. The president going to announce his pick for what is basically the most powerful economic position in the United States.
Exactly. And that's supposed to take place here in the Rose Garden later this afternoon. So here's the name. All eyes this morning on Jerome Powell. He is currently a member of the Fed. He was nominated to that post by President Obama. He is a Republican. He does seem to enjoy some pretty vocal support from economists universally in this country. He is formerly a Wall Street executive. And George, if he's confirmed, he would be the wealthiest Fed chair in recent history.
Okay, Cecilia Vega, thanks very much.